This is Fox 31 Now.
Good morning. You're watching Fox 31 Now. I'm Alex Rose. CDOT has a lot of construction planned for I-70 corridor that's going to impact your travel this summer. Let's go ahead and listen into the latest update.
From Golden to Grand Junction, and in Denver too. Our focus today is on the projects that impact the corridor from the Eisenhower-Johnson Memorial Tunnels to the Denver metro area. Project by project, CDOT is committed to turning this aging highway into a greatly improved and safer multimodal transportation corridor that all of us depend on. Whether we drive a truck to deliver goods, or drive our vehicles, or take a bus to reach our destination, whether that's home, work, or play. While we depend on this corridor, we are all too familiar with the potholes and ruts in the road, especially along the stretch next to us right now. And CDOT is working to remove those with sustainable improvements that we're very pleased to be getting underway. We are improving 6.4 miles of I-70 from Chief Hosa to Floyd Hill. And as many of you know, we are about to ramp up the bigger project on Floyd Hill, so we're taking this piece by piece to improve your travel experience throughout the corridor. You know, this is the most heavily traveled area along the mountain corridor as motorists enter the Rocky Mountains. About 61,000 vehicles a day travel this stretch. That's enough drivers to fill 80% of the Bronco Stadium. Guardrail work has started, and our contract crews will begin repaving in early June once we have consistently warmer weather. And folks will know it snowed this week, so we're not quite there yet, but we're getting into that season. We'll mill and grind nearly 467,000 square yards of asphalt, and we'll place nearly 65,000 tons of asphalt and install close to 3 miles of guardrail on this one project alone. Now, this is a state of good repair project. It's one of our smaller ones, but it's really important, and it will have such an impact on drivers' day-to-day experience. So it's a reminder, as we look at some of these bigger projects like Central 70 and Floyd Hill, that these kind of basic bread and butter projects have a huge impact on drivers' experiences as well. Most of the work will be done at night when the least traffic is on the road, because we want to have as minimal impact to the public as possible. Even with lighter traffic though, it's critical that drivers heed the signs, slow down, and pay extra attention to keep everyone safe. And particularly with multiple projects to improve stretches of the corridor, this is something we just want to reiterate over and over again. Knowing that we'll have this project, there's several important projects going into their second season just west of the tunnel, and many of those at steep grades where folks really have to keep a close eye on safety and on the road to make sure that we keep each other and the crews who are working hard to fix these roads and make them safe as well. You know, this is their office. We'll work through the summer weeknights to get the job done in the fall. And while this project is going on, we'll complete a system of variable speed limit signs and truck downhill warning systems along the Mount Vernon downgrade of eastbound I-70 into the Denver metro area. We'll also test new variable speed limit signs along eastbound I-70 between Empire Junction and Idaho Springs. These speed limit signs adjust to the latest road conditions, so traffic is moving at the safest speeds at that moment to prevent collisions. This is a relatively new system that we've been testing over the last couple of years. We sort of piloted it on the I-25 gap down towards Colorado Springs, where it made a big difference in terms of keeping the work zone safe. So as we embrace this technology, you know, please heed those signs. They will be changing for a reason, and know that this is a way that we can keep traffic moving, but also slow down when we need to. At the same time, over $50 million worth of work is getting underway to upgrade aging infrastructure at the Eisenhower-Johnson Memorial Tunnels. Now, this is a big portion of the backlog of state of good repair needs in the tunnels, and we're thrilled to be getting a big piece of that work underway this season. And this is thanks to the investments that we're making because of Senate Bill 260, which passed the legislature and was signed by the governor last year. In late summer and fall, we expect to start construction on early projects associated with the I-70 Floyd Hill project. And again, this is one of our flagship projects as part of the CDOT 10-year plan. And it's a big accomplishment to be getting that underway. And, you know, we're so excited to be able to finally get work off the ground. Those early projects will include new wildlife crossings at Genesee and Empire and roundabouts at Floyd Hill. And, you know, again, these are a prelude to the bigger project, which will be taking off in earnest after the design is complete over the next season and beyond. Over the next few years, you'll see better driving conditions on the I-70 Mountain Corridor, but that will mean construction impacts. You know, we'll do as much as we can at night. But again, motorists headed into the high country should plan ahead, be prepared for changing conditions, you know, heed the warnings and traffic signs, you know, mind the cone zones, and especially be careful for the men and women who are out, again, working in those work zones. With that, I'll hand it over to Mike, and he will talk about the challenges of keeping traffic moving safely and efficiently during construction. On to you, Mike.
All right, thank you, Director Liu. So again, my name is Mike Kellerman. I'm an engineer with CDOT. My program is responsible for I-70 from Kipling all the way up to Eisenhower-Johnson Memorial Tunnel, or EGMT as we say. I'm just going to roll through some of the projects we have and expand upon some of the ones that Director Liu had brought up during the beginning of this. Like she mentioned, right now our main project is from the top of Floyd Hill to Chief Hosa. We're doing that project with APC, and that project is at night. Again, it's a mill and fill project. It's kind of one of our tried and true methods. We'll be not only repairing the pavement, but doing much needed upgrades to the existing guardrail, replacing guardrail that's damaged, upgrading to a new profile, other things like that. So it'll be a nice project that, again, you'll wake up in the morning and it won't be the same as when you went to bed the night before. So that's the current project we have going on. Last year, very similar project. It was from Georgetown to Empire. So we're kind of piecing all these projects together and we're filling in the gaps. So we completed that project last year, almost exactly the same as the one we're doing right now. Next year, looking forward, we're going back to the west, and we're going to go from Eisenhower-Johnson Memorial Tunnel to the east, and we'll go down to Georgetown. So again, we're filling in that gap, and we'll be performing a similar project, repaving and upgrading the existing guardrail and making it a safer place. Last year, as most of the people standing here know, if you've ever driven up and down the corridor, we completed the westbound peak period lanes. That was a successful project, installing a toll lane from Idaho Springs to Empire. So again, that fills in that kind of gap there. And then moving forward, in 2024, we'll come back. We'll pick up where we left off at Chief Hosa from this year, and we'll go from Chief Hosa east to the Hogback. And so that will be a project we'll be looking at doing in 2024. And then the last piece will be from the Hogback to 32nd Avenue, and that'll be in 2026. We'll need a little bit of time to design and get that project out. As Director Liu stated, we've got a lot of challenges to completing these projects. We can't take a lane during the daytime. We'd have significant backups, and so we do the majority of this work at night. We also are battling temperatures at night. You know, a lot of this work is temperature sensitive when we're placing asphalt and things like that. And so over the years, we figured it out how to do it. And so how to get the work done, but keep people who want to get up to the mountains with that ability to do so. So again, it's through the work with our contracting friends like APC and our engineering crew and our maintenance staff. The majority of this work happens overnight while the majority of us are sleeping nice and soundly in our beds. Let me see here if there's anything I need to touch on. Again, during this construction, we urge motorists to slow down when you're approaching the cone zones. I think I saw numbers like, even at night, we get 13,000 vehicles on the stretch of highway, which is a huge number to me. And as Director Liu said, this is our office. And so please slow down as you're approaching the lights and the equipment and all the workers out there. And if you have questions, our website at cotrip.org or cdot.gov will give you up-to-date information as to what we're doing and when we're doing it. So at this point, I'll stop and answer any questions or whatever the next phase of this is.
I have a question. I'm Danny Tomlinson, live in Idaho Springs. waiting for the weekly register call. Is there a plan yet, or what's the timing on a plan for coming down Floyd Hill and either replacing the bridges, going in the tunnel, or whatever the plan might be?
We are getting underway on the full plans for the Floyd Hill project. The team just selected both a construction contractor and a design contractor. It is an alternative delivery project, which means that we bid it out so that the team can work together to innovate on the design. So they're working on all of that right now. The early projects associated with Floyd Hill will be getting underway this season while the team works together on finalizing the design and getting it into construction as quickly as possible.
So, kind of the design, if I'm understanding correctly.
The design's happening right now.
But there won't be any construction actually take place for
likely next season will be when the construction gets underway in earnest on the bigger projects. And part of the benefit of doing those smaller projects first is you can stagger the impacts to the traveling public. So we get the, you know, tick things off the list when we can do them, and then the bigger project will be underway in earnest likely next season. And, you know, one of the things that the team is working on is how to phase the construction of that project in a way that does what Mike talked about and absolutely minimizes the inconvenience that it causes. There's no way to do it without impacting traffic, but we know that it's a stretch that we can't just take out of commission.
Thank you. You talked about some of the planned projects. There's the unplanned projects.
Sure. There's been a tremendous amount of work in Glenwood Canyon over the past year since the events of last summer. As of now, you'll likely recall that after the mudslides that followed the fires, you know, there was a piece of the road that was taken out. It was at milepost 123.5 was the most severe impact. That's right at the Blue Gulch area. But there were other places where there were impacts as well. We worked closely with the Federal Highway Administration. Actually, the rapid turnaround time, they approved our getting underway to fix it within like 24 hours, which is really a record for the feds. And the work to actually fix the damage was done around Christmas. Just in this past week, the team finished another tremendous milestone in the canyon, which was finishing the work that was done in the Colorado River to sort of remove and shift the piles of debris that flowed into the river ahead of spring runoff season. So that was an incredibly important mitigation measure to be able to avoid flooding in the spring, and they just finished that, you know, again in the past week or so. Another project in Glenwood Canyon has just kicked off, and that's to sort of solidify some of the extra mitigation measures that we put in place last season. And, you know, we've been working throughout to, you know, keep doing more and more and more to get ahead of the risks that exist in that canyon. You know, whether that's our own maintenance crews clearing out the culverts to be able to improve drainage, you know, or fixing the rockfall fences, et cetera, et cetera. And they just put out a contract to take some of the innovations that were done last year, specifically the super sacks that we put in place to help catch water, and they've been working. So to make those more permanent, you know, again, just to add an additional layer of mitigation protection. You know, there will be continued work in the canyon over the years to come, as there has been in the years past. It's an area that takes a heavy beating constantly. You know, we've been repaving it in components, and, you know, unfortunately, one of the impacts of construction is that there's been a lot of truck traffic in, which, you know, has accelerated some of the decay, and we're going to be asking the federal government to help us pay to accelerate that too. But, you know, a lot of work to do everything we can ahead of spring has happened over the past year in the canyon.
It's a bit of a challenge to keep track of all the projects you guys are doing. Remind people if they're going out for a weekend how they can make sure they avoid some of these closures or backups.
We strongly recommend that you check cotrip.org before you head out, and, you know, use common sense in checking the weather. You know, in a place like the canyon, you know, if there's extreme weather, you know, it could mean that there's a closure. You know, much like last season, we'll be following a protocol where we look to the NOAA forecasts to take precautionary measures, you know, to close ahead of a severe rain event so that people don't get stuck if something happens. And, you know, again, we do everything we can to try and, you know, get ahead of the weather. So check CoTrip, check the weather. You know, use common sense. Don't try and be a hero if there's extreme weather conditions predicted.
But, yeah, and it's also, I mean, Floyd Hill, for example, if you're shutting down Floyd Hill, Highway 6. We talked about there are alternatives, but you've got to be aware.
Yeah, there are alternatives, and US 6 is the way that you would get around Floyd Hill. But, if there's severe weather, it might be better to wait until the weather improves a little bit to undertake your trip, because, the challenge of driving in the mountains, the same thing that makes them beautiful makes them hard to drive when weather conditions are severe.
So, I will add that you all will get a press release, and some of you already have it. This is a great information resource that will address one of your questions. This has all the information on summer traffic impacts, what's going on the I-70 mountain corridor from Golden all the way to Grand Junction. You'll see you can easily go there by going codot.gov, and then just in the search do I-70 mountain corridor summer construction. Should take you to the page. You'll also have the release. We'll have the links right in there, and you can see the maps, you can download those maps, you can use those maps, and please feel free to use those maps. They're high quality PDFs that you can use in your publications and also online and social media. And also for the public, they can go to cotrip.org and they can sign up for updates. We send out updates on Glenwood Canyon, for example. If you want to know what's going on there and what the impacts are, you can sign up for those so you can really be in the know. But as Shoshana said, we can't stress enough, you really got to know what the conditions are like. Even when it's a nice day like this, you need to know what the corridor is going to be like. Cotrip.org is a really good resource, and also monitoring the weather is incredibly important as well too. It's very different. Really, it could be even different from mile to mile on the corridor. So I hope that helps. Everyone, thank you so much. If you have any questions, you can either contact myself or Presley. You can also contact Elise Thatcher. She's got details on the west side of the...
And thank you, folks, for tuning into Fox 31 Now. I'm Alex Rose. Just a quick preview on some of the construction projects that are happening from Golden all the way over to the tunnel. And, I just spent some time to be able to pull up some of those resources that they were referencing. And we will have these on our website for our write-up on this story at kdvr.com and the Fox 31 app. I just find it certainly interesting to be able to kind of go through and see the different projects that are going to have an impact on I-70, because obviously that is the main artery to all of our summer fun here in Colorado. So they go by segment and really just outline the basic bullet points of what's happening over there. Even US 6 over through Clear Creek Canyon, they're doing repaving from Floyd Hill to Chief Hosa. And then we've already done some reporting on this, and you can find this on our website. A big one is going that's going to kind of be a chokehold, from what I can understand, is going to be the repaving project from Silverthorne all the way up to the tunnel. Now, most of these things, you heard in that press conference, they're going to try to be doing the bulk of these construction projects overnight, so there is minimal traffic impact. But some of these, I-70 is a long highway. It's going to take a lot of time to be able to do all the work to repave it and everything. And so some of these things are going to have an impact. But for example, I do know for the I-70 repaving from the tunnel down to Silverthorne and that whole segment, that is going to have an impact on lanes, Monday through Thursday. They're going to stop construction on Friday, Saturday, and Sunday when there is more traffic. Again, all these resources and all this information is going to be available to you at kdvr.com and the Fox 31 app. That's going to do it for me here on Fox 31 Now. I'm Alex Rose. Happy Friday, and I'll see you folks next time.